Good afternoon everyone and welcome to Compensation and Benefits Online Management Classes. Okay, this is Dr. Mahesh M. Vanjeri, Assistant Professor from Department of Management Studies, SDM College of Engineering and Technology, Dharwad. So this is the fifth session on chapter number 3 from unit 2. So before I continue the discussion part, let us briefly take a quick recap. Okay, let us take a quick recap of what we have discussed in the previous classes. Okay, so we are into chapter number 3, defining internal alignment. So far we have learned compensation strategy and internal alignment. Structures vary among organizations, and now we are learning what shapes internal structures. So I hope you can recall. Okay. Yeah. So we have started learning what factors influence internal structures, or what factors shape the pay structures. So we have learnt about the external factors. These are external to the company, and these external factors are faced in common by all the organization in an industry or in a country. Then we were discussing about the organization factors that influence internal alignment or internal structures. These organization factors are internal to the organization and they are only limited to the organization. So among them, strategy we have completed. Okay, so technology, human capital. Okay, I think we were till here, human capital. So I will continue from that point. So from external factors, yes, we have completed. Then organization factors, yes, organization strategy, organization's human capital, and yeah, here I think yesterday I stopped in this slide. So let me continue from here. So the third organization factor, okay, which shapes internal structure or which influences internal pay structure, is organization work design. Basically, it is the technology used in producing goods and services influences the organizational design, work to be performed, and skills or knowledge required to perform work. Okay, so say for example, if there is a retail store, there is a company which is a brick and mortar retailer. There is another company which is a online retailer. So brick and mortar, for example, Big Bazaar, Walmart. Okay, then online retailer, Amazon, Flipkart. So now both are into retailing. Okay, but the type of technology used in producing and delivering the services is quite different. In brick and mortar retail store, the employees wait inside the store for the consumers to walk in. Then they assist the consumers in purchasing the product, trying it out, as well as paying and checking out. And also sometimes customer services like alterations, or size change, etc. So if you look at the level of technology used in brick and mortar model is quite basic and different, where human intervention is more. But whereas in Amazon and Flipkart, the level of technology is used is high end, and the employees are not in directly touch with the customers. So that's why I said technology used producing goods and services influences organizational design. So if you consider a retail store, definitely you will have customer service associates. Above them, next level will be department manager, and above them, next level will be store manager. So this is the organizational design inside a store. Okay, so if you consider a online retailer like Amazon, such a structure does not exist. Okay, so it will have V-level employees like vice president, merchandise vice president, purchase, and so on. And there will be departments to assist these vice presidents in different functions or operations. Okay, so that's why the organization work design is influenced by the technology used in producing goods and services. Okay, then I mentioned about temporary work supplier or outsourcing specialists. Many a times, okay, people will be working in an organizations, but who will not be the employees of the same organization. So I was giving example of a software engineer, okay, from one of the Indian company. So who is going to Finland, okay, and working in a client's workplace, okay. So he is not the employee, but the client's work, since he is working in the client's workplace, that client company will be making payment for this employee. So in such cases, okay, so how that client company should pay for the employee of the outsourced company? So pay for employees under both practices, based on both practices means temporary work or outsourcing specialists. Pay for employees under both practices based on internal structure of the home employer. Okay, the client company in Finland has to consider the internal alignment or internal structure of the company in India and accordingly make the payment. Then delayering. Delayering is cutting unnecessary non-contributing work which eliminates one layer. Okay, so delayering means cutting unnecessary non-contributing work or eliminating one layer. In many developed nations, okay, usually if you consider a manufacturing unit, or generally we refer to them as a factory, okay. So in a factory, what you will see is a floor level employees. So generally we refer to them as blue collar employees, and above them there will be one supervisor, okay, who will allocate the duties of these workers, okay, in different shifts. Okay, he may maintain attendance as well as he will see to it that he will assign the work and he will also take the work. So what work is assigned, whether the his employees have done it or not. So now in many developed nations, okay, so these blue collar workers are organized into teams, self-managed teams. I repeat, so in many of the developed nations in manufacturing plants, these blue collar laborers are organized into self-managed teams and supervisors are eliminated. So these self-managed teams, okay, they within the team they perform the job of a supervisor as well. So that is what we call it delayering. So this again influences the internal structure of an organization, also affects the internal pay differentials. It adds work to other jobs. Okay, these supervisors, okay, who now do not have a job in the floor, okay, not necessarily be removed from the job, but they may move on to other jobs or adds work to other jobs. So when I give the example of self-managed teams in blue collar workers, along with their regular work, some additional work is added to their job, which is supervisory job. Then the job or role of the blue collar workers is enlarged, and then changes the job's value and structure. So these, okay, blue collar workers, okay, pay will increase because they will be shouldering additional responsibility, that of a supervisor. So these all factors in this way, okay, shape the internal structure or internal alignment of an organization. Then overall HR policies. Okay, see, basically the overall HR policies, okay, will come into picture in designing a internal structure. Okay, and the objective of designing a internal structure, I would like to recall you that of Lockheed Martin engineering department. So at the entry level, the designation is engineer, then senior engineer, lead engineer, systems engineer, and so on. The sixth level, highest level, is the consultant engineer. Okay, so what is the objective of, okay, so these kind of a internal structure is basically to give the employees a feeling of career progress. So the employees, when they join the organization in the entry level, the internal structure motivates them to work harder and get promoted to the next level. So some organizations, to give this feeling of career progress, who will have multiple layers, okay, or many levels in the hierarchy or in the structure. Okay, so though the salary will be, the salary differential will be quite smaller between the two levels, but yet there will be, since many levels the employees keep getting promoted, so though the pay differential is very low, but since they are promoted to the next level, that gives the feeling of career progress to the employees and keep them motivated. So this is how the overall HR policy shape internal structure or influence internal structures. Okay, then so we were till here, organization factors, how they shape internal structures. We completed a discussion on strategy, technology, human capital and HR policy. So we'll move on to the remaining two factors or two organization factors. So combining external and organizational factors. So basically the labor market combines external and organizational factors. Okay. So there are certain rules and procedures that determine pay for different jobs within a single organization and allocate employees among those different jobs. Okay. So in these rules and procedures definitely and directly influence the internal structure of an organization. Okay, so when we say internal labor market, okay, all employees of an organization working globally, I repeat, internal labor market means all employees of an organization, okay, working globally becomes a internal labor market. Say for example IBM, okay, is working in many countries and they have software development centers as well as employees working in many countries. So an employee working in India can apply for a job which is vacant in America. So this is what we call it as internal labor market. Think about Walmart, world's largest company. I think 1 million employees work, okay, for Walmart. Okay, but provided the policy, employee can apply and work in other store, other offices or other countries of the same organization, that is what we call it as internal labor market. So this way internal labor market also influences the internal alignment or internal structure of an organization. Then there are definitely within the organization, so even I remember my brother who works for IBM, he mentioned, so there is an internal job market inside IBM and an employee of IBM is eligible to apply, provided he has the required qualification and eligibility, is eligible to apply in other software development center in India as well as abroad. So while enabling this, there will be some rules and procedures that will be laid down within the organization which determine pay for different jobs within a single organization definitely and allocate employees among those different jobs. We'll refer exhibit 3.5. So as you can see here, illustration of an internal labor market. So this is again of Lockheed Martin. Okay, so Lockheed Martin hires only engineers and senior engineers. Okay, so I repeat, Lockheed Martin from external market, this is what is called combining external and organizational factors. So Lockheed Martin hires only at first two levels from external labor market or job market, engineers or senior engineers. Even an engineer may get promoted to senior engineer within the internal labor market. And Lockheed Martin does not, okay, hire engineers from external labor market for these three jobs: systems engineer, lead engineer and advisor engineer. Whereas again they hire consultant engineer from external labor market, and for all systems engineer, lead engineer and advisor engineer, it's only internal promotion. They promote an employee who is already working in the organization. It may be anywhere in the world. Okay, if the he or she is eligible and willing to appear for the selection process, they promote the employee from within. Okay, so this is what exactly we are talking about: internal labor market and allocating employees for those different jobs. Okay, so definitely when you do it, say for example, when you promote the internal employees, his job changes. Okay, when he gets promoted to the next level, his job enlarges, his pay differs, and the internal structure changes. Then employee acceptance. Definitely, the internal alignment, which is designed by an organization, or the internal structure, the number of levels, okay, and the pay differentials, the criteria used to decide the pay differentials between two levels. Okay, for example, the salary between the engineer and a senior engineer. I hope you can recall, we considered those figures. So those should be acceptable to employees. Okay, those pay differentials, the job profiles, and the internal structure should be acceptable to the employees. Okay, so procedural justice means, for example, okay, say if an engineer is getting promoted as a senior engineer and there are other engineers as well who have joined along with the same person in the same batch. Okay, the other employee should have clarity on why only this engineer is getting promoted as senior engineer. Okay, that is what we call it as procedural fairness. And distributive justice is, okay, implement proper implementation of the internal alignment. So whatever levels have been defined and the pay differentials has been considered and the criteria considered to pay the pay differentials, the criteria considered to promote the internal employees in the internal labor market. So all should be properly implemented and executed. So we call it as a distributive justice, means pay according to the internal structure which is designed. Then if it is not acceptable to the employees, definitely the organization has to make some changes to the internal structures. Then pay structure changes include in response to the external factors such as skill shortages. Okay, say for example, there are particular skilled jobs. Okay, so we have been considering to so many types of jobs now. Okay, including Lockheed Martin, IBM, Walmart, Amazon. Okay, so if there is a shortage in the external labor market, okay, for a particular skill set or employees with particular skill set, okay, then again it directly affects the internal structure of the organization. So though, let us say, there is a compensation which is already defined for a particular job, since the shortage of the skilled labor for that particular job, okay, the company might have to change that pay structure and increase the pay to attract the shortage of talent in the labor market, external labor market. So this is how these factors, okay, shape internal structure or influence internal structures. Okay, so now I will take a pause here and I'll go for your questions. Okay. Yeah, students. Sharan. Can you hear me? ओके अक्षय कुलकर्णी, कैन यू हियर मी? आई एम नॉट एबल टू हियर योर वॉइस शरण. शरण और अक्षय कुलकर्णी. ओके ओके या जस्ट अ मिनट. हाँ यस शरण. अक्षय कुलकर्णी आर यू स्पीकिंग? ओके इवन विथ इयरफोन आई कैनॉट हियर यू. मे बी वन मिनट. ओके ओके या आई नो यू कैन हियर मी बट इवन आई वुड लाइक टू नो व्हाई आई एम कैन नॉट हियर यू. Okay, so if you have any question, let us check that later. What is the technical problem? Put it in the chat box. If you have any question, type it in the chat box. Okay, if you have any questions, type it in the chat box. Okay. So in that case, okay, first let me take attendance. Okay, then I'll continue. If this class will not stop, it will can continue. So if you are unable to give your call, 1 minute, then let me take your attendance from here in the attendance. Aishwarya present, Akshay Kulkarni present, Ankita is present, Apeksha is present, Arpita is present. 1 minute. Arpita, no. Yeah, see, I am taking attendance based on the number of people. Okay, so do not type or speak because it will change the order again. So Arpita is absent. Ashutosh Kulkarni present. Ashwini is present. Geeta is present. Geetanjali is present. Meghna Kalburgi is present. Meghna Lokhande is present. Then Nagaratna present. Navya is present. Nidhi is present. Nikita is present. Nikita. Oh, I cannot see Nikita. Nikita is absent. If she is there, she can type it in the chat box. Only Nikita. Then Pooja. Present. Pranjali is not seen. Prema is not seen. Priya is present. Varsha is present. Samuel. Samuel, I cannot see. Sharan is present. Sharayu. Sharayu is present. Shilpa, yeah, I cannot see her. Shreya is present. Srinidhi. Srinidhi is not here. Shweta. No. Snehal. No. Suchitra. No. Maruf is present. Vaishnavi. No. Okay, Ankita, I have marked present. Srinidhi was present, okay. Just got disconnected. Srinidhi, I will mark present. Srinidhi is marked present. Ashutosh is present, okay. So all attendance is good now. Okay. Okay, am I now audible? Sharon, can you speak now? Or you can type in the chat box. I will check. Okay, so you can hear me. Okay, and can you see the PowerPoint slide? Okay, PPT is visible. Okay, thank you. Okay, so now we are coming to the last part, okay, of the chapter, that is strategic choices in designing internal structures. So I repeat, strategic choices in designing internal structure. So fitting or tailoring the pay structure to be internally aligned involves two strategic choices. Okay. So strategy is about how. Okay, so far what we considered was which factors influence internal structure. Now we are addressing the question how to align the internal structure. So fitting or tailoring the pay structure to be internally aligned involves two strategic choices. The first one, how tailored to organization design and workflow to make the structure. How tailored to organization design and workflow to make the structure. And second strategic choice is how to distribute pay throughout the levels in the structure. Okay. So there are two approaches. One is a tailored versus loosely coupled. Okay. Tailored approach means well designed jobs with the detailed steps or tasks. There are very small pay differentials exist among the jobs. Okay, so the moment when I say like big bazaar store, customer service associates, department manager, assistant store manager, okay, so these all jobs are well defined and designed. The job profile is very clear as to what should be done on the job, what are the tasks to be performed on the job, with detailed steps on how to perform the job, or with details of all the tasks to be performed by the employee. And the pay differentials will be generally, okay, it's not always, pay differentials will be generally low among jobs. So this approach or this strategy is called as a tailored approach. Okay, so what we are learning? Fitting or tailoring the pay structure to be internally aligned. Okay, how to fit the pay structure to be internally aligned. Okay, that is what we are learning. So one way to do it is a tailored approach. So well designed jobs with detailed steps or tasks. Very small pay differentials exist among the jobs. And in other companies, let's say loosely coupled. Okay, where if the company is an innovative company like Tesla, for example. Okay, so in such companies where innovation is prime, even Medtronic, for example, that way, who are the pioneers in the surgical medical equipments like stents and pacemakers. Okay, so these are basically innovation companies. They're called as innovation companies. So you cannot define a rigid job profile for a researcher or for R&D employee or for an engineer. Okay, so many a times to develop a new product or in research, cross-functional teams are formed. Cross-functional means people from different departments come together and work towards research and development. So in such a case, you cannot define the job profile or tasks or steps for a particular job. So we call it loosely coupled. It usually happens in innovation companies. So it which requires constant innovation, but this loosely coupled approach, okay, has to be frequently reviewed and also changed to suit the requirements of the different projects or tasks. So simple way, tailored means written, predefined, so according to which each employee will perform his or her job, okay, and the pay will also be determined in writing. So whereas loosely coupled, okay, so the job is having a broader scope, okay, and people from or employees from different departments come together, form a team on a project, and they again go back to their department, okay, again they join on another project. So these are called as loosely coupled approach. Okay. Yeah. And one more. Okay. Strategic choice is egalitarian versus hierarchical. Egalitarian, we already learnt about it. It means it's a political philosophy. All are equal. Okay. So which company consider this? Whole Foods Market Incorporation, if you can recall, the retail chain of restaurant chain or retail chain of stores in US, which sells only organic food. Okay, and its products are free from preservatives and chemicals. So egalitarian means all are equal, means the pay differences between the levels will be very little. Hierarchical means there will be vertical hierarchies, okay, and the pay differences between the employees differs, okay, to a greater extent. So again, you can recall Lockheed Martin's engineering department, that is hierarchical. And Whole Foods Market Incorporation, okay, the approach was egalitarian. So egalitarian structure sent the message that all employees are valued equally. So if you can recall the example of a Whole Foods Market Incorporation, the retail chain in US, okay, so the employees are, okay, paid performance based incentive based on the team performance. Inside the store, all the employees are divided into a team of 8 to 10 employees, and each team will have a benchmark, okay, and which they have to achieve. And if they achieve, they will get $1 or $2 extra per hour paid, the all members in the team get. So that, and if that team does not perform according to the standards, or if they don't achieve their goals within a given period of time, they are not entitled for that additional remuneration per hour. So everybody in the team loses it. So that is egalitarian structure. Okay, the best example is Whole Foods Market Incorporation. Advantages of this approach include fewer levels and smaller differentials between adjacent levels. I hope now you can understand what is the meaning of this. And between highest and lowest paid workers. So you can recall again, okay, even in Whole Foods Market Incorporation, the salary paid to the executive level employees is not more than 14 times the average salary of all the full-time employees. I repeat, in Whole Foods Market Incorporation, the retail chain in US, the salary paid to the executives is, okay, not more than 14 times the average salary of the all full-time employees in the organization. Okay, that is a very extreme extent of a egalitarian approach. Okay, so when I say 14 times is high, okay, dear students, the salary of executives employees, okay, many a times is as high as 200 times, 300 times higher than the average salary of full-time employees. Okay, so the advantage is, okay, fewer levels and smaller differentials between adjacent levels and between highest and lowest paid workers. And you can recall, even the company maintains a register where you can see in the entire last year what salary is paid to which level employee. But disadvantages include averageism. Okay, brings to light that equal treatment can mean more knowledgeable employees feel underpaid. See, if you can recall, one of the students asked a question. So in the team, okay, if the team achieves, okay, everybody in the team gets an additional pay of $1 to $2 per hour. And I don't remember, but maybe it was Ashutosh who mentioned that what if somebody, okay, does not work equally, contribute equally, he or she also gets paid that additional remuneration. See, that is the disadvantage of egalitarian approach. So averageism brings to the light that equal treatment can mean more knowledgeable employees feel underpaid. So that means, okay, if within a team, if there are underperformers, okay, if who are not contributing equally in the team, even they will get paid the equal treatment, equal, okay, incentives, okay, as that of the employees who are putting equal effort or higher efforts. So this definitely demotivates the more knowledgeable employees or those employees who are putting more effort or contributing more compared to other employees. Okay, so either they will reduce their amount of work, okay, or they will switch the organization and join a competitor's organization. So that is the disadvantage of this approach, egalitarian approach. Okay. Okay, so students, it's 41 minutes since continuously I'm engaging class. Okay, so egalitarian versus hierarchical, I'll continue in the next class. Okay, so I hope till here. Okay, so we are clear. So now I'm going to, okay, take off these slides. And if you have any question, okay, so still my voice you can hear, that's good. So if you have any question, please type it in the chat box. Okay, Aishwarya, any questions? Okay, Srinidhi, no doubts. Aishwarya, any questions? Okay, Pranjali has joined now. So I'll mark her present. Pranjali is marked present. Okay, if anyone else joined in between, okay, and whose attendance is not marked, please type your name in the chat box. Okay. So I'm asking for attendance also. If anyone logged out due to poor internet connectivity and logged in between after taking attendance, you can type your name into the chat box. Okay, 1 minute time, then I will end meeting. Okay. Okay, so it looks like attendance is clear, thorough for all, and many students have typed, no questions, no doubts. Okay, so then thank you for your patient listening. So see you in next class. Okay, thank you everyone and have a pleasant evening. Thank you.